Hey, we got Cole Sprout here, attending Valor Christian High School right now to Colorado. It's posted PRs, amazing PRs across all distances, and these are from last season. So obviously as a senior, I'd expect these to go down even more. But last year he posted times of 153 and 800, 404 in the full mile, 3,200 meter of 840. Perhaps some of you guys in here from California may have seen him do that in person at Arcadia Invitational. In cross country, he's been top 10 at NXN both junior and senior year, and he's committed to come out to the Bay Area where we are over at Stanford University. So welcome in, Cole.
Thank you.
We have one question that's in chat right now. Of course, guys, fill up Q&As. Give yourself an opportunity to ask some questions, Cole, today. I have one question in there already right now, so I'll bring you up, Morrell, and you can ask a question to Cole.
What's up?
So it's kind of a tradition in these social distancing meetings to ask the speaker for their middle name. But Renny's not here today, so she asked me to take over for now.
Yeah, my middle name is Christopher.
Nice.
Yeah.
Do you have a real question for Cole, Morrell, while you're up here?
Yeah, I do, actually. So I heard again, well, I already knew, but you ran the 153 and the 800. I know it's not your main event, but or not really like an event you run most of the time, but what's your mentality for the race, really?
That's a good question. I would say most of the time I just kind of go hard from the gun. I don't know if I have much of a strategy other than just sprint. I guess for most people it's not really considered a sprint, but since I do kind of like the longer stuff, for me it's kind of just an all-out thing. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, usually I try to come in and first lap, like I think that was like a 56 or something, and then just try to hold on, maybe negative split. But yeah, that's kind of what I have going in there.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah, for sure.
Hey, Cole, do you want to talk about real quick here how's life going for you? What's been this spring? How's this changed for you so far?
Yeah, it's definitely been different. But yeah, I think for me, it's helped to just kind of maintain the same kind of rhythm in training. Races and competition obviously look different, but those time trials that I've been doing a little bit have been kind of just helping just break up the monotony and everything of training. But we'll see what the rest of the spring looks like, but hopefully I can get at least one type of a race in at sea level or something. But just kind of staying optimistic right now. But yeah,
that must have taken a few days or maybe a week to kind of adjust to the news, or were you prepared for it?
When it kind of first started happening, like it was like the week leading up to New Balance where they, you know, canceled New Balance indoors. I kind of expected it, so it wasn't like too much of a shock, but I don't know. It definitely was not ideal, but I kind of saw it coming, so that did help a little bit
for sure. Well, we got some more questions coming in now, so Nick, you're gonna be up next. I see you at the top of the list right now, so Nick, I'm gonna bring you in.
Hi Cole, I wanted to ask you, do you have any challenges coming down to sea level, like when you went to Arcadia in California, since you're so used to Colorado's altitude?
Honestly, I kind of see it as a benefit whenever I go down. There's a lot more oxygen, so that definitely does help. I'd say that really only challenge I have is just like the travel aspect, just getting kind of used to to the altitude and everything, but it doesn't usually give me too much of a problem. Yeah, if anything, I feel better. So, yeah, I enjoy coming down to sea level, though.
That's good. Thanks, Cole.
Yeah, for sure.
So whenever you guys run a time and altitude, do you guys do a conversion to sea level times, or is that something that's common in your area?
Most of the time, we don't. Not an official conversion or anything, but yeah, I mean, a lot of the guys up here just try to get at least one race down at sea level. So I mean, for cross country, that usually looks like the Desert Twilight or NXR. It's not like technically sea level, but just like that difference is big enough to get some nice PRs and stuff. But yeah, for the most part, we just have our raw times. Unconverted for altitude.
What's the altitude where you are?
Where I live, it's about 6,000 feet. So we're a little ways out there.
Yeah.
So it feels nice coming down to sea level for sure.
All right. I got Gabriel with the next question here.
Okay. Hi. So I was wondering, like, it seemed to me at least that you committed to like a school a lot before a lot of some other athletes. And I was just wondering how like going to Stanford feels for you, and what do you think about like running there?
Yeah, so I kind of first fell in love with the team. I know a lot of guys who already go there and are going there. And from what they told me, they loved it. You know, I talked with Liam a little bit last year during Arcadia. Who goes there now and is a freshman. And yeah, he really loved the, you know, just the atmosphere and the kind of the chemistry the team has. And on my visit, that kind of sealed the deal with the team aspect. And, you know, a lot of it's just developing, a relationship with the coach too. You know, I just felt like I could trust Santos with kind of getting me to where I wanted to be these, you know, next 4 or 5 years and maybe even beyond that. And then academically, like I wanted a school that you know, I could excel and do my best at. So Stanford was kind of a no brainer at that, you know, point of view. So yeah, just kind of checked all the boxes really.
Thanks, Gabe. Cole, do you have any plans of breaking 4 minutes in the mile by the end of this year?
I ideally, yes. Initially I was going to go down to the Music City Distance Festival in Nashville. That's kind of where I had my PR last year in the mile.
Last year.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's an awesome meet, but it did get postponed till at least late July, if not August. So I don't know if I'll extend my season that long, but, yeah, hopefully there's some sort of meet I can do. You know, before I kind of shut down the season and get ready for cross, but yeah, we'll see.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, Garrett, you have the next question here.
Hello. So what's your favorite off distance event? So like maybe not an 8, 16, or 32.
Well, I would say to do probably like the 400.
Okay.
I'll hop in the 4x4 every now and then.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's kind of just a fun little change of pace. But, yeah, and to watch, I'd probably say like the pole vault just because it's so scary. I would never do it, but it looks cool. So, yeah.
Well, then what would an event that you haven't done – What event would you want to do?
Yeah, I'd probably, well, I don't know. I'd probably say like the 100-meter dash or something, because I don't know. I think it'd be cool to be a sprinter, but obviously I'm not a sprinter. Yeah. So
fair.
So Garrett will be going to Cal next year, so you guys might.
Yeah, I'll be racing you. That'll be fun.
Sweet. Yeah.
Looking forward to it. Garrett ran 152 last year in the 800s, so he's he's done pretty well in the.
Thank you.
For sure. Congrats. Yeah.
Look forward to racing. It'll be fun.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Like the comment that just came through.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah, it's all good. Look forward to racing you. That'll be fun.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
All right, thanks, Garrett.
Thanks, all right, thanks, Garrett.
All right, Dominic has a good question for you coming up here.
All right. Sweet.
All right, so I've already asked this question to Jace, but I like getting everybody's opinion. So you're obviously considered many, if not all people, a very great runner. So what would you consider the difference between being a great runner and a good runner is?
That's a good question. You know, at the end of the day, I would say it's not so much physiological, but mental. You know, a lot of running, and I think what separates the best from, you know, the good is just like being able to really push beyond what you want or maybe what your body wants. So yeah, I mean, I've done a lot of kind of reading and research on it because I think it's fascinating, but yeah, I mean, the mind is just like any other muscle that can be strengthened and
trained,
improved. So yeah, but I'd place like the mind is kind of what separates it.
Thank you.
Yeah, for sure.
Thanks, Dom. If you don't mind me digging a little bit deeper into that, is there any mental exercises that you do personally that, you know, you feel like separates you from the rest or things that you've taken advantage of as far as that mental training?
I don't know. I wouldn't say there's really anything specific. I don't know. I would say like, I don't know. I mean,
do you visualize?
Visualizing is something I do try to do before races. And I find that really helpful. Even like self-talk, I found to be really helpful for like, just like, I don't know, encouraging yourself and getting yourself to that next level. So when it does start to hurt, being able to like tell yourself like it's okay and, you know, to keep pushing, I found to be really important. But yeah, I haven't done any like actual, strength exercises. But yeah, I want to try to for sure. Mm-hmm.
Sounds good. We got, 4 more questions from the audience here for you.
Perfect.
All right. So, Tor, you're going to be up next here. Get you in here.
Hey, cool. So this kind of relates to the last question, like mentally, but I was wondering when you're going through like a really hard part of a race, like cross country nationals or something, or like a 3200, what's going through your mind? Like when you're really in pain, like what keeps you running? Do you have like a thought process then? Or?
Yeah, no, that's a good question too. Yeah, I just try to like kind of what I said before, just talk to myself. Ask myself how bad I want it, you know, because it does hurt a lot and a lot of myself is telling myself to stop. But yeah, when it really does start to like hurt, I just like imagine the finish line and how close I am and how, you know, how hard I've worked. So yeah, it's just a lot of self-talk really. And then at the same time, kind of just like shutting off the part of your brain, or at least trying to, that's telling you to stop. So yeah.
All right, thanks, man. Thanks, Tor. When you guys come up to ask a question, feel free to thank our guests for your answers. Let's see, Abby, you've got the next question here. She's got the big question, the why question.
Oh, perfect.
Why did you start to run?
Yeah, I started in like 8th grade. That was the first year I did cross country. And really it was just because my sister wanted to run cross country. So I was like, well, I might as well try it. And I don't know, I really liked the purity of it. and how it's, I don't know, it is about competing with other people, but at the same time, it's about like improving yourself and seeing how far you can kind of push yourself physically and mentally. And I just like that kind of aspect of it. So, yeah, it's kind of why I started running.
Thanks, Abby.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, Mr. Dillon, you're up next.
Even those impressive times.
Wait, what was that? I don't think I heard you.
Yeah, I think your question got cut off. Repeat it.
How long did it take for you to get those impressive times?
I mean, I guess, like, technically it took, like, 5 years or so. But, I mean, it just takes consistency and hard work. You know, showing up to practice every day, willing to work. So, yeah, I'd say it's just, like, cumulative of all the years I've been running and all the work I put in and focusing on the little things outside of practice. So, yeah, I mean, I'd say it's just everything.
All right. Thanks, Dillon. All right. Next question is coming from Kieran. Coach, do you have any questions for Cole right now?
Like looking at the next few years at Stanford, like what do you feel you can improve the most as, you know, taking into effect, I mean, as part of your running, what do you think you can improve the most?
You know, I'd say like just, I don't know, some of the harder workouts where I do them alone just because I don't really have anybody to run with me. I think having guys to like pace with and run with, I think that's going to be huge to just improve in that area. Yeah, I don't know if there's anything specifically I would work on right now. I think ideally like speed and turnover is something I want to really work on. And I think that will kind of follow as I, you know, start practicing with the Stanford team.
Do you know what you think will be your best distance in college? I mean, what would you say is your best distance now in high school and track?
Yeah, I mean, I would probably say like the 2 mile is my best distance. And yeah, I want to try the 5K, you know, next fall or whenever. Because I think that'll also be a good event for me. But yeah, I'd say like the 2 mile and the 5K are kind of where I'm at. But I also love the mile. So I don't really know. I could go one of a couple ways, I think.
Yeah.
Hi, Cole.
What's up?
I was just wondering, what would your schedule be in terms of training through track season? Because I'm more of a 400, 800 guy. And I was wondering what would like longer distance compared to from what I'm seeing from my own teammates.
Yeah, I mean, it definitely does kind of depend on if you're more of a high distance guy or low distance guy. But I do like a couple doubles a week just to get, I'm at about like high 50s, 60s like my max right now for the spring. So, yeah, I would say, like, I do kind of like a workout 3 times a week. And that's usually like a tempo type workout. And then, like, race pace intervals, so like 400s or 300s at either mile, 800, or even 2 mile pace, something like that. And then I have like a long run. And yeah, either like, some surges or short intervals in, like in my run, kind of like a fartlek. So yeah, it could be any combination of all that. So it just depends on the week.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Yeah, for sure.
So what's tempo pace for you right now?
Right now, I'm at about 5:15, 5:20 is where I'm at. And I think I'll get down to probably like 5 flat, maybe a little bit faster.
Yeah. And Cole, what's do you do any supplementary work on top of the running?
Yeah, I do lift twice a week. And a lot of that's just to make sure I'm all balanced and preventative just so I don't get injured. But I do try to strengthen some areas that are weaker, so like adductors and glutes, hammies. I mean, really all lower body and then some upper body just to make sure I'm strong all around. Mm-hmm. But yeah, a lot of it is just to kind of make sure I'm healthy and everything. So
just asking for those instructors out there to make sure that they know that they can still strength train and still run very well. And that, do you feel like you needed? Do you give a lot of credit to that? Or do you feel like in some ways you can still emulate pretty close to the time without it?
I think it definitely does help. You know, like, I think for one, it does keep me healthy and I don't get injured as much, which is kind of the name of the game, is staying healthy, being able to race and run. But then also, like, it does help me be more efficient as a runner, you know, whether that be more snappy on, like, impact, you have a better turnover. Like, all those things can, I think, like, can be influenced through doing some strength work. So, yeah.
Thank you for the answer. Will, I'm going to bring you in. I've got a question about Stanford.
What's up? After Stanford, do you plan on going pro, or do you actually plan on like majoring or doing a career?
I mean, I would love to run professionally. I think that's kind of like the big goal, is to run professionally and or try to qualify for the Olympics. So, yeah, whatever that looks like. I mean, I'd love to do that, but you know, you also can't really run competitively professionally forever. So I do plan on pursuing a career after or whenever after I'm done running. So.
Okay. And I wanted to ask, like, since you train in Colorado, do you think that's going to be a big change going to California?
I think it will be a little bit different for sure, but I think it will just like be more beneficial than anything, just going down to lower elevation. I'll be able to do workouts faster without being quite as fatigued, which is, you know, great for getting in you know, better shape, obviously. But yeah, I mean, I think like I won't have, I don't know, yeah, I think it'll be good overall, but you know, it'll be probably tough coming back to elevation during the summers or something to run. You know, but other than that, I think it'll be good. So.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, for sure.
Well, we've got our youngest one in our chat that's going to come up and ask you a question here.
Sweet.
Fifth grader. Connor, you're on mute right now.
Have you ever done a different sport than track and cross country? And if you did, what was it?
Yeah, so I've done a couple other sports. Before I ran, I did mountain bike racing. So like cross country mountain bike racing. So it was kind of similar in that like endurance aspect of sports. So that's one of the reasons why I started to run also. But I did like tennis and I did like lacrosse for a year. But yeah, I kind of jumped all around.
Thank you.
Yeah, for sure.
Thank you, Connor.
All right. And Gabe has a second question. This is our last question we'll go through. And Cole, we appreciate your time, you know.
Yeah, definitely.
So, Gabe, I'm going to bring you back up here for a second one.
Yeah, thanks so much for coming and doing this, Cole. But my second question is, what I've been doing a lot recently now is like easy runs, long runs, and things like that, because like coronavirus and stuff like that. But I was wondering, when you're doing a run that isn't necessarily a speed workout, and you're not, and you're feeling like pain when you shouldn't be, or like fatigue when you shouldn't be, what's your like go-to thing to do?
Yeah, that's a good question. Yeah, I mean, a lot of the kind of easy runs and long runs I do are based on kind of how I'm feeling. So if I do feel like extra fatigue that day, I'll go ahead and run a little bit slower. Because at the end of the day, an easy run is supposed to be easy, in my opinion. So, you know, I won't sacrifice a workout the next day or whatever just to keep pace. But yeah, and then like making sure I'm hydrated, because, you know, I find like one of the main reasons I'm extra kind of fatigued after a workout is if I haven't been hydrating or kind of eating how I should be. So yeah, just making sure I'm kind of doing the little things to recover well. And yeah, usually that seems to work. So
thanks.
Yeah, for sure.
Cole, if you have a bad race, right, quote unquote a bad race, yeah, how do you deal with that with moving forward in your progression?
Yeah, I don't know. I think as kind of sucky they are, there's a lot to learn from kind of those races where things don't go quite as you wanted them to. So, I mean, for me, I like a specific example is last NXN where, you know, I did okay, but it wasn't, you know, where I wanted to be, kind of going into the race. So, you know, after that, I think, I just found like how it could turn into a positive situation and kind of find ways to, you know, improve on my weaknesses. And also like realize like one race doesn't define you. So, just keeping perspective, because I think that it's easy to, you know, lose perspective of what's really important. And, you know, that running isn't just about running a certain time or getting a certain place. So, you know, it's easier said than done, but, you know, I think races like that are good reminders of just keeping everything, in perspective. So,
what is really important to you?
You know, at the end of the day, I am a Christian, so that's kind of like my foundation of why I run. So, I mean, at the end of the day, like it's about glorifying God through running. And, if I'm doing that, then in my opinion, I'm succeeding. So even if I do have a bad day, I think, you know, it's not the end of the world, and there's still ways of, glorifying Christ through it. So.
Cool. Thank you for that answer.
Yeah, definitely.
Albert, do you have any?
One final question. So how often do you check results of other top runners from other states? And do you guys communicate with each other and kind of check, see what people are doing, like workouts wise or anything like that?
Yeah, I don't check like mile split a whole lot. I am pretty close to a lot of those guys just because we've, you know, raced a lot together and gone to different camps together. So, you know, we have like some group chats where we just kind of see how each other's doing. And, you know, I follow most of those guys on Instagram or on other social media platforms. So, as you see, like kind of what they're up to training or racing wise through that. And, you know, it's cool to see just because, you know, even though we are like competing against each other, you do like to see those guys succeed and, you know, perform well. So, you know, it's a cool dynamic.
Cool. We really appreciate your time being with us. If you could, you know, kind of close out this session with maybe just some advice, for, you know, the runners that are here watching.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I'd say just, keep doing what you're doing. You know, I think for me personally, I find just keeping a rhythm and, I don't know, keeping some sort of sense of normalcy, that really helps me. So, yeah, just keep doing what you're doing. That's all I'll say. Yeah.
Thank you, man. We appreciate your time and thanks for everybody being in here too.
Yeah, thank you.
Good luck in your training, man. We'll see you here in the Bay Area soon.
Yeah, for sure. See you then.
Yeah. Bye.